What's going on, man?
So, to finish watching Smoky Ribs do up a Cajun pulled beef sandwich thing. Looked awesome. Inspired me a little bit. Earlier today, I'd been looking at some videos and something I've always wanted to try but was really intimidated. It's tamales. So I got me a rib roast, and it's going to go over applewood, and we're going to slow smoke this thing. We're going to start out per Smoky Ribs advice. We're going to smoke it, good solid smoke, as you can see coming out of this right now, for 1 hour. After that, we're going to pull it, throw it in some juices, put it back on there. All right, so we got our rib roast. Got a little bit of a brown sugar type rub thing on it, and I'm gonna use this stuff a little bit later. Let's get this on there. We are hanging at a solid, right now it's about 270. We're gonna dial it down to about 240. I'm gonna double check the, I've never done a big roast like this, I'm smoking them, but I've always wanted to try. This thing was 50% off. Yay, let's do this. Oh. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Is that bad boy in there? Right in the center. I don't have any probes, so I'm gonna have to play this by ear. But right now, I can get dialed in at whatever temp. I gotta go check it out. I think it's 240. Get dialed in there, maintain that for about 1 hour, and I'll bring y'all back. All right. All right, then. We are an hour into it. Been hanging right at about 240, 250. Doing good. So let's go ahead and get it all fixed up. Nice. That's pretty. And I forgot the little forks and stuff to stick in there. So we're going to burn my hands. Actually, that wasn't that bad. All right. So now what we want to do, get this cranked up to about 325. Get her all opened up right now. Bring the heat up, and then we got her in here. Now what we're going to do, throw in some beef broth. Want to get this up about a third of the way up the roast, according to Smoky Ribs, the roast over there. And then we're just going to let this roast, I guess, whatever you want to call it. Unfortunately, I bought this Ready Check model ET732. I've got about 6 cooks into it, and the best way I have found to use this thing is like that, because that's about all it's good for. It. This thing's a piece of shit. Sucks. Someday I'll be able to get me one of them damn fancy eye grills with the two probes and get all snazzy about it. So let's get our grill set up. What you want to do, we want to pull out our grate and grate it. That out front now. Toss that right, y'all. And if dogs lick it, they're going to be sucking butt. We're going to throw in a couple drip trays here, 50-50 water and apple cider. That's going to help keep it a little bit more moist. And this is going to be a pretty long cook. Get those in there. That back up here, I'll bet that burned your little tongue, didn't it? Just like so. Toss that right on top. Now, once we get to 325 degrees, we're going to sit back and wait. See how it looks when we're done. All right, y'all. Ah. All right, we are about 8 hours into this, and we should be about good now. I took it out of the pan, and according to Russ, for beef to pull apart, it should be about 205 to 210. So right here we're looking at 200 right there, 204, 205. I think
we're gonna do 207. It's kind of a thinner spot. It's a real thick chunk, it doesn't even hit 202. We're gonna go ahead and pull it off, put it in some aluminum foil, wrap it up, tint it, let it finish cooking off in there, see what happens. Let's just get this in here.
And like I said,
I did. We're gonna let that bad boy sit. And next time you see me, we're gonna be tearing it apart. Alright, see you guys in a bit. Okay, y'all, let's give this a shot. Damn well smells good, I'll tell you that much. Oh yeah. Eat some of them claws. That'd be badass. It's coming apart pretty easy. That's nice. Still hot as hell. Should let it sit a little bit longer. Russell's right. About 205 is a secret. Alright, I'm gonna get this torn up. And before I go mixing in the sauce, I'll bring y'all back. Alright guys, looks like we're ready to sauce it up. We got nice pull. That came out real nice. Russ, you were dead on, man. Got some burnt ends here. Look real good. We're gonna sauce up all this stuff. Unfortunately, I'm all out of my Coakleys, and I'm all out of my You Know You Want It sauce. I need to get some more. What's up, baby? We gotta get some sauce on there first. What's it think?
Good.
Alright.
Tastes good without sauce.
Good. We're gonna put some sauce on because these are gonna be tamales tomorrow. Alright, now let's get this mixed up in there. Gotta get in there with your fingers. Of course, this is the first time I've done pulled meat. Besides pulling my own, you know. Back up.
Taste it
was about 18 bites ago. Man, that was good. Real juicy too. After 8 hours, beef in the smoker. I'm really impressed with how moist this is. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Good?
Good.
Is that enough sauce, you think?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try a piece. Just enough. That's good. Toss these burnt ends around here. And there we go. We're done, guys. Russ, Smoky Ribs, really want to appreciate, or want to thank you for the inspiration to do this. But this is going to be the end of this part of the video. Tomorrow, I'm going to do up some... I'm going to do up some tamales using this. First time ever. I've never made it before. So, see how that goes. This is the first time I've done this. This came out awesome. Talk to y'all later. Thanks for watching, and hit that like button. And if you're not subscribed, subscribe. But hit that like button too. Give me a comment. Tell me what you do differently, or what you'd like to see me do. I'll talk to y'all later. I gotta stop her before it continues. See you guys.